Good morning. It's still morning, so good morning. My name is Lynn Bell. I love hearing everybody else's stories, what everybody else had to say. I actually found it very fascinating. I am a 31-year resident of Miami-Dade County. I've lived in Homestead for 21 years, which is the southern tip of District 8, which is the commission seat that I'm running for. I'm the former vice mayor, former councilwoman, and former mayor of the city of Homestead, and actually the first and only woman mayor in the city's 100-year history. I bring to the table a lot of experience, but you know, what is my life? What do I do? I'm a wife, I'm a mother, I'm a grandmother of seven. I have seven grandchildren, by the way, I'm very proud. And one more grandchild on the way. My youngest daughter lives in Alaska, so that will be grandchild number 8, and she will be Cora Crabtree. By the way, all the other seven grandchildren have Hispanic last names, from Maldonado de Leon and Encarnacion. So, Abdulio, you can thank me for pronouncing your name properly. I am looking so forward to serving this district. As a former mayor, former vice mayor, former councilman, plus such conservative credentials. I know many people get up in different situations, and many people can talk a good talk, and that's okay. But you guys will see the real deal, and you'll see the real deal with Lynn Bell. I am the former president of Florida Right to Life, the former political action committee chair of Florida Right to Life, and I'm currently the delegate from the state of Florida to the National Right to Life Board of Directors. And actually, I'll be meeting on Tuesday. Remember 17 years or so, and I'm leaving on Tuesday to the conference in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, where I also will be conducting a workshop myself. I will be one of the speakers. So I look forward to it. I have had the pleasure of the last 6 years of serving the residents of the city of Homestead in government, in politics. I know about balancing a budget. I know when you're the hardest hit city in the area of tax revenues, we had a 25% drop in property values last year. There's a 30% drop this year, so they're really going to have a handful. I know how to cut the size of government. My first year, we cut the size of government by 11%. We went from a city, we were the fastest growing city in the United States for a city of its size, and I took the city manager's office from an office of 5 down to an office of 2. I know how to We cut the size of the government by 11%. We cut the $11 million off of the budget without compromising city services. We know how to cut the fat. We know how to cut the fluff. You need leadership. We all need good leadership in county government. You know, I get tired of hearing county hall is broken. It needs to be fixed. Let me tell you, we do definitely need an adjustment. If there's a chiropractor in the room, you know what I'm talking about. County government definitely needs an adjustment. You know, the myriad of challenges that county government is faced with is just unbelievable, but it's not insurmountable. We can do it. We can work within the Jackson Health System. We can restore that and restructure that system to where it's a working system. It is inexcusable to me that you would have a governance, the board that would oversee Jackson Health Systems, and they would allow millions and millions of dollars to be squandered. They're not even properly billing patients. They're not even collecting co-payments when they can. I've been studying the issues. It's inexcusable when you have a South Dade government center where the majority of your services have been closed and you're being told if you live in the southern part of the county, sorry, you need to drive downtown Miami to Northeast 11th Street. You have to go downtown. That's inexcusable. You need a voice who's going to stand up for you and fight for you and say, we want the restoration of services. The county does not end at Kendall Drive, I promise you. And there's a big district down here that I'm looking forward to representing every one of you on. I'm one of 6 children. My husband is one of 6 children, and his youngest sister is also Down syndrome, and so that really hit home with me. I also know what it is to raise 3 daughters. We experienced an unplanned pregnancy in our own home, so we know what it is to put our money where our mouth is. I'm an adult Sunday school teacher of women, adult Bible study leader. I'm a mothers of preschoolers mentor. I mentor the women. We have something called Angel Rooms Moms in our church, where we provide cribs and diapers, anything that the mom needs. We also offer parenting classes to these young mothers, and we've seen them bring in the dads, we've seen marriages, we've seen broken families fixed, all through something called Angel Room Moms and a parenting class. Miami Herald actually did a story on Angel Room Moms. at New Beginnings Christian Fellowship, which I've been a member of for many years. So I thank you. I look forward to serving you, and I'm very excited about what we're going to do with your campus. Thank you.